Guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today is Friday, November the 22nd, and it's payday. So I'm going to be busy today and tomorrow going through and paying some of my bills and paying off some of my old medical bills and things that I've been paying $5 and $10 a month on. And I know a lot of y'all can relate to that fact that, you know, whenever you're sick and you have to go to the doctor or the emergency room and then you're left with a big copay, and sometimes you can only manage to pay it off by sending $5 and $10 a month. But that's okay. The hospital doesn't mind. The end result is all that they're looking for, and that's to get their money, no matter how long it takes. So I'll be doing that today and tomorrow, and I have to get insurance on my car and all those things. So I want to thank you for watching my videos and making this payday possible for me, because without you, I would not have the YouTube channel, and I would not be able to earn the income from my YouTube videos. So thank you so much for the time and all the effort that you put forth into watching my videos and leaving me the wonderful and beautiful comments that you do. It really lifts my spirit, and the comments and the interaction that I have with each and every one of you means so much more to me than the paycheck. And I want you to know that that's the real reason that I make these videos. And I hope that you continue to enjoy them. And if you have any suggestions for future videos, I'm open to suggestions. And I will try my best to make a video on the subject that you would like to talk about. So today we're going to announce that I finally have all the names written down for the drawing for the gummy bears and the warheads. So I have started the listing here for the gummies. And then, of course, the warheads, as I was going through my comments, they came down to about right here. So instead of wasting space on the paper, I just started listing more names for the gummies. So there we go. So that's one page. And here is the second page. And another page. We have a lot of interest in this delicious candy. And let's see if there's another page. Yes, another page. Now, I will be going back through all the comments, through all of my videos from today all the way back to when Zeus was here making the candy. Especially the video where we announced the giveaway. That's where most of these names came from. There's another page full of names. And let's see if that's the last one. No, one more. So I have 184 entries for the gummies. Yeah, I have the totals written down there. And then what is it, 73? Yeah, 73 entries for the warheads. So if you haven't had a chance to enter your name yet, go ahead and just put gummies or warheads or both in your comment below, and I'll make sure your name gets on this list. I still don't know yet what day the drawing is going to be. I've been very busy this week, and I will get into that in a minute. But hopefully, I will try to do the drawing on Sunday. I do have an obligation for tomorrow. I will try to sneak in a video if I can, but I won't be doing the drawing for the gummies or the warheads. So we're going to aim for Sunday. Don't write it in stone, because I'm not making any promises, but that is my goal. So I'll be cutting these out, and we're just going to do the drawing the old-fashioned way. Just put all the names in a bow, and I'll pick three names out, because I'm going to give away 3 5-pound bags of gummies and 3 of the big the little cases. I guess there's 12 maybe in the pack of the warheads. So y'all be looking forward to that, and good luck. I wish all of you good luck. But I want to tell you a little bit about what I've been doing all week. I stopped doing the weigh-ins every day because, frankly, it was just getting to be boring to me, and I would assume that y'all will probably get tired of it too. And then I had so many people telling me, Glenda, don't weigh yourself every day because that will discourage you and you know, make you want to give up hope on losing the weight. But like I said in the beginning, my healthy living lifestyle journey is not about losing the weight. That's not what I'm going to focus on. But it is about feeling better. You know, I'm just sick and tired of being sick and tired all the time. I mean, it had gotten to where I was having to lay down and rest every morning after I got up and had my coffee and ate breakfast and took a shower. You know, I don't have time for that. I have a YouTube channel to run and videos to make and things to do and places to go. You know, I promised y'all that I would be going into Manhattan and making videos. Well, the way that I've been feeling the last 6 to 7 months, there's no way possible that I could pull that off. So I'm doing it for me, I'm doing it for my YouTube channel, and I'm doing it for all of y'all who watch me every day. You deserve someone healthy telling you stories, and that's what my aim is. And if I lose a few pounds here and there, that would be just icing on the cake, which I won't be eating any of that either. So just remember, if you're going along this journey with me, just, you know, have your water with you and just drink, drink, drink. That's all I do is drink. So I want to keep, you know, all the salt flowing out of my body. And I haven't had any sugar, except I did relapse on Zeus's Grand Marnier chocolate covered pecans. I made a mistake and put them back in the refrigerator, not in the freezer, and I ended up getting me a handful last night. But the good thing about it, they gave me a tummy ache. Not because of them being Zeus's chocolate pecans, but because I have not had a speck of sugar in my diet in 12 days, and I think my stomach just bloated up and reacted to that. Of course, I'm still not fully unpacked and settled in my apartment, and there was a Tums nowhere to be found. But I found an old Prevacid, so I took that, and everything finally got unbloated and settled down. It was like sticking a needle in a balloon and letting the air out. So I know y'all don't want to hear about my stomach problems and all of my ailments. But what I was getting to about being so busy this week, y'all have heard me talk about my friend Linda, that I met her when I took care of an elderly gentleman. She was my relief. First, it started out I was her weekend relief, but then things happened along the way, and she didn't want to work full-time anymore. So I ended up doing the 4 days a week, which were Thursday through Monday. And then she would do... I would leave on Monday morning, and then she would do Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, and I would return on Thursday morning. But Linda's situation is very difficult. It's difficult for her living it. It's difficult for her friends who have to see her struggle and try to get by on Social Security only. Living on Social Security is a huge challenge, and it's a challenge that none of you want to have to go through whenever you retire at the age of 66 or whatever it is that the federal government is moving the age up to now, 67. I mean, wouldn't you love to be able to retire when you're maybe 58 and not 68? Well, I encourage you to start preparing for your retirement. Even if you're in your 50s, start saving your money and cutting back on your debt and your expenses, and cut up some of those credit cards with a high interest rate and pay off the high interest rate credit cards first. That's what I did, and I finally got out of credit card debt, and I will never apply for another credit card. My credit is ruined anyway. I doubt I could get one, so that's one of the benefits of having bad credit. You can't get any more credit to mess yourself up with a lot of debt. But I really need to listen to my own preaching, because I really haven't saved. Not like I should have been saving this year, since I started receiving my my YouTube checks in January. even though I've had a YouTube channel for 2 years, and I got monetized after about 11 or 12 months. But then after you're monetized, there's no paycheck coming in. AdSense has a limitation on the amount of money that they will issue a check for, and it's $100. So whenever you first get monetized and you're a small, struggling channel, and you see those ads on your channel and you're so excited, it doesn't mean you're going to get paid, because it might take 3 or 4 months to accumulate that $100 in your AdSense account. So with hard work and perseverance and dedicating your life to your channel, that's basically what it takes. And if you're like me, like I was when y'all first started watching my channel, you know that I didn't even have money to buy milk and eggs and bread at the end of the month. I lived like that for a good year, waiting to get a Social Security check. And the reason that I started this YouTube channel was so that I could hopefully eventually monetize it. And I thought, well, maybe I can just start telling little short stories about my life growing up in South Mississippi. I didn't know if anybody would be interested in listening to those stories. I didn't know if I could ad lib on them a little bit and make them fun and interesting, because the stories of my life are not fun and interesting. I had a very difficult childhood, a very abusive childhood, neglected and abused and emotionally scarred basically for life. So I had to overcome all of that, and I had to figure out a way. If I'm going to sit here and tell stories about my life, I have to make them interesting. I can't always be a Debbie Downer. Y'all, I can't say that without thinking about Saturday Night Live and Debbie Downer. Oh, God. If y'all haven't seen those episodes, you got to go back and look for those on YouTube. But I didn't want my channel to be a Debbie Downer. I wanted it to be an uplifting channel. I wanted people to be able to relate to me and my struggles and my adversity in life. And I wanted to portray the message to never, ever give up hope. There was a period in my life after my son Jeremy was killed in 1997 that I didn't want to live. And I didn't even make an effort to survive. In fact, I did just about everything that I could to end my life. But God saw me through that. He knew that I had a message to give. Of course, back in 1997 through about 2007, you know, I don't know when YouTube started, but there was no platform to sit here in front of a camera and tell your story. So God knew then that I had a story to tell and a message to give and to try to lift y'all up and to give you hope and encouragement and to stress to never, ever give up. Even in your darkest times, when you feel like there's just no hope and that you cannot put another foot and your foot in front of another one, you can't take another step, you can't get out of bed, you want to pull those covers up over your head. I've done that many, many times. And now that I look back, I realize I didn't try hard enough. I should have had more strength and not let that bad and sad and dark period in my life continue for 10 years. You know, that's 10 years of my life that I will never recover. I'll never get it back. But if I can use it to help y'all, then that's my goal. And that's my hope in my life now, to sit here and tell my stories. And, you know, I do add some little humorous events now and then, and most of them are true, but I might throw in a few things so that just to make y'all laugh and chuckle. But you know, I'm doing it all in good faith and just to make the stories interesting. I mean, when you watch a movie and you see a funny part or an interesting part or even a sad part, you know, it's probably fiction, but you know, my stories are true for the most part. And so I want to get back to my storytelling. I think I left off at when I was about 35 and up to the point from birth to when my daughter Jill was born. So we still moved probably another 20 times even after Jill's birth. So I do have a lot of stories to tell, and a lot of sad stories, but mostly happy stories and stories of strength and endurance. So a little bit about my friend, my friend who lives on Social Security only. The reason that I asked my son and daughter-in-law, my son Jason, he's my firstborn, and my daughter-in-law BB, to step in and help me out this week is because I've been busy helping Linda. And, you know, it's just, I just wish that I could do more for her. I just wish that I could maybe pay her to help me with my YouTube channel or something, you know, so to help her with her income. I have told y'all the story before. It was a long time ago. I don't know if you remember it, but Linda was married to her first husband for 9.5 years. They got a divorce, and she worked for the bank for a while, which did not pay a whole lot of money, but she did pay into Social Security for, I'd say, a good 30 or 40 years. But she, you know, she's older than me. She's about 8 years older than me, and so that would make her about 76. And because she was not married for the required 10 years, you know, whenever you divorce someone and you try to claim their Social Security, you can't get it unless you were married to them for 10 years. Of course, when she was young and divorced her husband, she didn't know about that rule, you know, or surely she would have stuck it out for another 6 years. But when you're young and you get divorced, you think, well, I'm going to meet another wonderful man and remarry. But sometimes that just doesn't happen. Okay, I'm going on 17 minutes, so I'll try to end it within 20 minutes. I don't want this to be a soap opera. So what I'm getting at is Linda lives on $600 a month. She's homeless. The reason that she was working full-time as a live-in when I met her about 10 years ago was because she needed a place to live. And here she is in her late 70s, and she's still having to work as a live-in. So she has a job now as a live-in caregiver in Staten Island, which is not too far from me. And she got sick this week, and she needed help. You know, she can't afford a car or a car payment. So she had no transportation to get to the doctor. So I drove to Staten Island 2 days this week and went to see about her and picked her up at the house where she's doing the caregiving. And, of course, the family had to get a couple of people to come in and fill in for Linda. Of course, she won't get paid for that. You know, when you do caregiving jobs, it's not a salary job. It's salary in the way that you get paid, you know, per day for however many days that you're living there and taking care of the elderly person. But if you go out for a week or two, then the pay goes to the person who has come in there to fill in for you. So I did go to Staten Island a couple of days and took Linda to the doctor, and she got medicine, and I talked to her this morning. She's feeling better and doing much better. She does have a grown adult daughter who has remarried now, and the adult daughter has two of her own children, and the man that she married has four daughters. So they do have a house full. Of course, Linda is welcome to stay there and sleep on the sofa whenever she doesn't have a live-in caregiver job to stay at, or when she can't afford a motel room. So I just wanted to let y'all know that that's where I've been this week. That's what I've been doing, and it's all for a good cause, and now Linda's doing better. So hopefully I can get back on track, and we'll do the drawing for the gummies and the warheads. Yay, so excited. Thank you, Zeus, for donating this candy for my subscribers. And y'all, I want you to know that he has gotten so attached to y'all. He just loves every one of you. He knows you by your name. And you'll see him responding to y'all every now and then. I trust this man with all my heart, and I love him deeply. And I always will love him. He's just the truest and the best friend that I've ever had. And it is such an honor to know you, Zeus Phillips. So I'm going to end this because I'm babysitting today. There's a little girl in there taking her morning nap, and she's going to be waking up soon. So Grandma has to get busy and get her lunch made and get my lunch made. So I'll probably try to make another video. I'm not sure I'll do it in the morning, but I'll get it done sometime tomorrow. Marie Galloway sent me two Scarfies, so we're going to be having a Scarfie modeling video coming up, and another Scarfie drawing. We're going to be giving away two Scarfies, and I have been contacted by another amazing female-owned, American-made product, and I'm going to be endorsing it and giving that product away. So y'all just fix yourself up, put on some lipstick, put on your dancing shoes, and turn the radio on and put the Bee Gees on, and let's just have some Saturday night fever and have fun. So I love you. Please give me a thumbs up and share my videos, and y'all just keep on coming back. Bye, guys.